do you think is the signature style of an entrepreneur today?
I'm going to give you my take on what is appropriate and what I like. If you see, my style is more simple. I try and stick to the more classy blacks, blues, browns, grays. I don't experiment very much. However, that is a little bit contradictory to the style of the entrepreneur today. I think people want to make a statement. They're more experimental. Some of them are very casual as well. So you see, big CEOs with simple black t-shirts and blue jeans, whereas, you never imagined something like that, 10 years ago, or, MD or CEO not wearing a suit. So it's very experimental, it's very out there. I think it's because we're in the kind of, world that we are in today, where everyone's so, connected, everyone wants to be very unique. So you see what's been happening historically over the years, and you want to just kind of step aside and be different and be unique. So I think that's where it stems from.
What about watches?
So what I've seen happen is that people, more than product, I think they are attracted to brand, and brand which is more niche, brand which has a very unique DNA. So we see brands like Daniel Wellington coming about, very simple. You see a NATO strap, you see a very simple white dial, right? But it's doing extremely well. It's taken all over the world. It's a very great strategy through social media, where they've adopted various bloggers integrating within their brand. So brands like this that set aside some kind of a very unique USP,
digital watches? Do you think digital watches are outdoing the mechanical ones?
So I wouldn't say outdo, but they certainly are denting a certain market share. I mean, it's not a coincidence that with the launch of a digital watch, the Swiss industry saw 2 years of recurring decline, which is something that the Swiss industry did not see for more than a decade. So I don't think that was a coincidence, and it was, I felt like it was a little bit predictable as well, because at the end of the day, the whether it's mechanical watch or quartz, the property that we own on the consumer is their wrist. Now, if there's going to be another product which is going to replace the wrist, that is going to dent our market share. I don't see it as being extremely sustainable, though, to be very honest. That's my hope as well. Yeah, that is my hope as well. But I think a lot of brands are doing quite a bit to catch up to that space. So you see all the known brands like your Fossil and Guesses and Tag Heuers of the world that are being as relevant as possible and sticking to the smartwatch tag. But I think more than smartwatch, to be honest, I think it's a sample. So if you see like a Motorola and whatever, they've not really caught up to speed. But it's Apple that has really dented the market, which was what is expected.
The strategy to sell your product,
yes,
is moving towards social media.
Right.
With respect to watches, how much do you agree with it?
I think with any industry, be it watches or even mobile apparel, whatever it is, I think social media is extremely important. I think we talk about it now more, but it's actually become a hygiene now. So like how you would have a department of finance or logistics or operations or marketing within a company, social media is part of hygiene. You have to do it to move forward. If you don't have social media, you have one leg missing. It's like that. For aspirational products, yes, but for products which are more need-oriented, I think Google does a very good job because their conversion rates are much higher. There is intent from the consumer, so you're able to target a more more focused consumer, somebody who has intent to buy.
And your favorite watch brand is?
My favorite watch brand is Guess watches and GC watches.